Hi, gang. I finally found an old PC monitor and turned it into this easy-to-make, powerful high-voltage power supply. And here the PC monitor is flying this lifter. I'll show you how I made it, followed by some demonstrations. Here's how I made it. Since this monitor was discarded by someone else, I first test if it still works. It does. But some monitors have a power-saving feature, whereby if it isn't connected to a running computer, then it doesn't work. So I try it with no computer. You can see by this message that the display works. That's important, because the high voltage we want is the same high voltage that goes directly to the display tube, as you'll see. Next, I open it up. This thick cable is what we're mostly after. It provides the high voltage. Right now it goes inside this rubber cup and to the display tube, the cathode ray tube. If the monitor has been turned on recently, then there may still be a high voltage danger under that rubber cup. I don't touch that yet. First, I work on the ground side. When you apply the high voltage from this monitor to something, like my lifter for example, you have the high voltage wire going to the lifter, but also a wire that goes to earth ground. Here's the plug that plugs into the wall. When it's plugged in, this long prong will be connected through the wiring in the wall to earth ground somewhere. Inside the monitor, it's this green wire. Somewhere I need to electrically connect to that wire. That wire is connected to a metal plate down here, which is also connected to this metal plate, and others. So I prepare two long wires by putting connectors on one end of each. I then get two sets of nuts, bolts, washers, and star washers, and bolt the wires through existing holes in the metal plate, making sure to make good electrical contact. Next, to work on the high voltage side, I start by making sure it's safe. Now that I have grounding wires, I plug in the monitor so that they're actually connected to earth ground, but I don't turn on the monitor. I tape one of the wires to a plastic stick. With an insulated pair of pliers, I lift up one edge of the rubber cup and put the end of the ground wire under it, until it makes contact with the metal connector underneath. That discharges any remaining high voltage on the wire, making it safe. I don't want the high voltage going to the display anymore, so I unclip it from the display tube. I cut the wire close to the rubber cup. I then strip the insulation off the end, being very careful not to cut the wire itself. I measure where the wire will come out the cover, mark it on the cover, and drill a big enough hole. Now to assemble it all. I drill another hole in the front, at the top, for one of the ground wires, and run it through. I put the other ground wire through a side hole, while the high voltage wire goes out the top. I want to put this connector on the end of the high voltage wire, so I can connect to this ball, but I think it would look cooler up here. So instead I solder on a wire with thick insulation, and insulate the connection well with tape, and heat shrink. I then put the connector on the end of that wire. I hot glue together a plastic holder for the bolt. I put the high voltage wire's connector on the bolt and put the bolt in place and then the ball. And the high voltage side is done. I tape the ground wire that goes out the side back onto that plastic stick. This is to be used as a handy discharge stick. Notice that I added a few more holders as well as a few labels. Done. Time for some fun, with a lifter. Here's the setup. The high voltage positive output is connected to the thin wire at the top of the lifter. Meanwhile, the foil, or skirt of the lifter, is connected to these two resistors. Make sure you use around 240 kilo-ohms, and rate it for at least 2 watts, in order to protect the delicate monitor from high current sparks. That then continues onto the ground return side. I press the switch. It looks promising, but some adjustment of the lifter is needed. I turn it off, and use the ground discharge stick to discharge any charge left on the ball, and on the lifter parts. After some adjustment of the lifter's top wire, I leave the monitor switch turned on, and instead plug it in to give it power. This time the lifter flies. I'm curious what the voltage is, so I have my FLUKE 80K-40 high voltage probe plugged into my analog meter. Once the lifter's flying, I touch the ball with the probe tip. The meter shows around 2.4 volts DC. Which is really 24 kilovolts. And here's the lifter in the dark, so you can see the corona. Well, thanks for watching. See my YouTube channel, rimstar.org, for more videos like this. That includes one on how to make one of these power supplies from scratch, that's smaller, another on making a slightly lower voltage and even smaller one, that I call the cube, and the one explaining how the ion propulsion works that makes the lifter fly. And don't forget to subscribe if you like these videos. or give a thumbs up, or leave a question or comment below. See you in a bit.